Welcome to Discovery School's virtual learning platform. Good day, Basic 2 pupils. Today we shall be looking at mathematics, and our topic is capacity. What did I say? Capacity. Capacity is spelled as C A P A C I T Y. Capacity. So, going into this topic, we'll be doing a little experiment. Here I have a can. Here we have a bottle of water. Here I have an empty cup. And here I have a can for refill ink. I repeat, here is a container, a bottle of water filled, an empty cup, and an empty container for refill ink. We want to use this experiment for you to understand what capacity is. This experiment, or after this experiment, I believe you know what capacity is all about. So let's empty the water in this bottle into this empty cup. Watch me as I do that. Do you notice that the cup is filled and the water is pouring out of the cup? Okay, what can you deduce? You can deduce that this container, which is this bottle of water, or this bottle, is bigger than this cup. In other words, it holds more water than this cup. Whenever you put water into another container, you discover the container gets filled. You should know that that first container holds more liquid than the container you are pouring that liquid into. So we say this bottle holds more water than this cup. What does that mean? Or we can also say the cup holds less water than the bottle. In other words, that means that this bottle has more capacity than the cup. The bottle has more capacity than the cup. So from there, what is capacity? Capacity is the carrying ability of a container. In other words, we can simply put, for you to understand, capacity is the amount of liquid a container can hold. The amount of liquid a container can hold. So capacity is the amount of liquid a container can hold. I repeat, capacity is the amount of liquid a container can hold. So the amount of water this container can hold, or this bottle can hold, is called the capacity of this bottle. The capacity of this bottle is the amount of liquid this bottle can hold. Therefore, capacity is the amount of liquid the container can hold. The amount of water or liquid this cup can hold is called its capacity. So, we also mention liquid. What is liquid? Because water is not the only liquid. Liquid is the substance that takes the shape of its container. Liquid is a substance that takes the shape of container. When we poured water into this cup just now, you saw that the water started flowing on this table. As you saw the water flowing on this table, it has different shape. It was moving from one point to another. It could not stay because there is no container to contain that water. So, by the time you pour this water into this cup, it takes the shape of the cup. That's why we say liquid is any substance that takes the shape of its container. That takes the shape of its container. But when you go higher, you also know that liquid is a state of a matter. Liquid is a state of matter. Matter has three states. We have the solid state, we have the liquid state, and the gaseous state. So, liquid is a state of a matter. Liquid is also a state of matter. Matter is anything that occupies space. So liquid is a state of matter. Matter has three states. I think it got higher classes you've been told. Solid state, liquid state, and gaseous state. Then, let us look at examples of liquid so that you know what are the things. Examples of liquids. What are the things that you can put in a container? One of them we have mentioned is what? Water. Water is spelled as W-A-T-E-R. Water. Another thing is milk. Milk. Milk is a liquid. Though we have the powder form of milk, but we have a liquid form of milk. So milk is also what? A liquid. Milk is spelled as M-I-L-K. We have oil. Your cooking oil, your palm oil, your whatsoever oil, engine oil, they are all liquid. And oil is spelled as O-I-L, oil. O-I-L, oil. Another liquid is juice. You have five alive. Five alive is a juice. You have so many juice. You say, mommy, but Capri Sun. Capri Sun is also a juice. Those of you that like drinking Capri Sun. So Capri Sun is a juice. Tea. Tea is what? A liquid. Tea is what? A liquid. How many of you have taken tea this morning? Tea is what? A liquid. Tea is a liquid. You have so many liquid. And that liquid is all called petrol. Petrol is spelled as P-E-T-R-O-L. Petrol. Fuel is spelled as F-U-E-L. Fuel. Another one is kerosene. Kerosene. K-E-R-O-S-E-N-E. Kerosene. So we have a lot of what? Liquids. So we reverse by saying that capacity is the amount of liquid a container can hold. I also told you that liquid is a substance that takes the shape of its container. I also told you that liquid is also a state of matter. Matter is anything that occupies space. Matter has three states: solid state, liquid state, and gaseous state. Is that clear? Then we went on to examples of liquids. Examples of what? Liquids. So water, milk, oil, juice, tea, petrol, kerosene. What about minerals? Your Coke, your Fanta, your Sprite, your Pepsi, your Mirinda, they are all liquids. for today, for your activity for today, you are going to check around your house. You are going to mention 10 liquids. Activity, liquids. Mention 10 liquids. Thank you very much. I hope you had a nice time with me. Go to your new method mathematics for primary school book 2 math textbook on page 151. You will see a lot of objects there, different objects and their carrying capacity. In other words, if you look at what they contain by way of the first 175 ml, 18 liters, 240 ml, 2 liters, just like that. Thank you very much. I hope you had a nice time with me. I'll be back shortly.
You have learned a lot. You can join us via our website at www.discoveryschoolsng.com. You can visit us at Alboa Campus 11, 21, 23 and 25 Benin Technical College Road, Ugbowo, Benin City, and at Upper Mission 268 Upper Mission Road, Benin City. Thank you.